Please all rise for the national anthem of the Vatican City and the Philippines.
Parade of colors by the Knights of Columbus.
Thank you.
Please be seated. As we prepare ourselves for the beginning of the Holy Let us include in the name of the Father, and of the Spirit. Amen. Merciful. Strength in their commitment, protection from the disease. We pray for those afflicted. May they be restored to health. Protect those who care for them. Grant eternal rest to those who have died. Give us the grace in these trying times to work for the good of all and to help those in need. May our concern and compassion for each other see us through this crisis and lead us to conversion and holiness. Grant all this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever. Amen. We fly to your protection, O Holy Mother of God. Do not despise our petition in our necessities, but deliver us always from all dangers. O glorious and blessed Virgin, amen. Our Lady, health of the sick,
pray for us.
Saint Joseph,
pray for us.
Saint Raphael the Archangel,
pray for us.
San Roque,
pray for us.
San Lorenzo Ruiz,
pray for us.
San Pedro Calungsod,
pray for us. Please remain kneeling for the personal and family consecration to the Sacred Heart of Jesus. Lord Jesus Christ, we consecrate ourselves to you today, each one of us and all of us together as a family. Your Sacred Heart, the heart of your crucified and risen body, is the ever-living source of mercy and grace, hope and love for all of us. We desire to pledge ourselves and our lives to you in return. Teach us to be always united with you through your Holy Spirit, in mind and heart, in all our thoughts, words, deeds, joys, and sufferings. Grant that we may ever know you more clearly, love you more dearly, and follow you more nearly. We wish to share in your redeeming work in our world, that your Father's will may be done on earth as it is in heaven. That the civilization of justice and love may thus be built up in our land. Heart of Jesus, help us to keep sin away from our lives. Help us to keep loving, serving, and forgiving one another. Live in our hearts and in our homes always. Make us wholly yours. With your mother's immaculate heart, we renew our consecration to your Sacred Heart. For the greater glory of our Father in heaven. Amen. Jesus, Mary, and Joseph, be with us and bless us now and the hour of our death. Amen. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Please be seated for a while. Good morning, brothers and sisters. Welcome to Christ the King Parish. The holy sacrifice of the Mass will be offered by the Most Reverend Charles John Brown D.D., Apostolic Nuncio to the Philippines, with our local ordinary, the Most Reverend Honesto F. Ongtioco, D.D. Let us all rise and unite our hearts, minds, and voices as we begin the celebration.
Thank you. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Peace be with you.
And with your spirit.
On behalf of the Santatlo, the priests, religious, and consecrated people, and our lay people, I'd like to formally welcome us, our dear Apostolic Nuncio, Most Reverend Charles Brown, D.D. Thank you, Your Grace, for accepting this invitation. Your presence makes the Holy Father visible to us. You know that our faithful have a special love for our church and for our Holy Father. So we would like to take this opportunity to renew our commitment to the Holy Mother, the Church, and to our dear Pope through you. Again, Your Grace, welcome to the Diocese of Cubao.
Thank you very much, dear Bishop Honesto Ongtioco. It's great to be here in the Diocese of Cubao to celebrate this Mass in the Parish of Christ the King. It's a great joy for me as your Apostolic Nuncio to be with you this morning, especially on the feast day of Corpus Christi and the day in which we celebrate the gift of Jesus to us in the Blessed Eucharist. I'm so happy to be with your parish priest, Father Orosio, and also, as I said, with your dear Bishop Honesto Ongtioco, who yesterday celebrated the 24th anniversary of his episcopal ordination, his ordination as a bishop. So, dear Bishop, congratulations on your anniversary. Let's give him a round of applause. When Jesus instituted the Eucharist, he established it as an act of thanksgiving. The words of institution are, he took bread and giving thanks, broke it, and took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, gave it to his disciples. The Catechism of the Catholic Church describes this as consecratory thanksgiving. The two substances, bread and wine, are signs of gratitude, first seen when the priest Melchizedek offered bread and wine to thank God, the Creator, for the fruits of the earth. The Greek word eucharisteo means to give thanks, an act of thanksgiving to God. The entire Mass is a prayer of thanksgiving, which is stated explicitly in some of the prayers and is implied throughout the entire liturgy. Today, with great joy and thanksgiving, we celebrate the solemnity of the most holy body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. We also commemorate today the 40th anniversary of the dedication of your church and altar, actually the 60th anniversary of your parish and the 40th anniversary of the dedication of this beautiful altar. And we also gather in thanksgiving for the gift of the Jubilee year, which comes to a close today. In thanksgiving, we partake of Christ's flesh and blood, who alone brings us the assurance of resurrection from the dead and life everlasting. While everything else will perish, this alone is the food that lasts unto everlasting life. And so let us take advantage of the opportunity to worthily receive Jesus in Holy Communion. If only we receive who it is that we receive in the Eucharist, we will not hesitate to say, Lord, give us this food. The one whom we receive is he who said, I am the way, the truth, and the life. I am the resurrection and the life. He is the one who also said, I am the living bread come down from heaven. Whoever eats my flesh and drinks my blood will have eternal life, and I will raise him up on the last day. So, dear brothers and sisters in Christ, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries.
Thank you. Gloria in excelsis Deo.